Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your man Chris Thorns. As always, good morning, good afternoon, good evening, whatever you're watching my content. And as always, like, comment, subscribe, and share. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm coming to you with an update. Y'all know any of these children stories that I talk to you about, past or present, I try to keep up with the updates. And we do have an update on a child that some of y'all may not have even thought about in quite some time. But let me see if I can refresh your memory on the child we're going to be talking about right now. So let's go over to one of the newsrooms. All right, ladies and gentlemen. Y'all remember this precious child right here? Taylor Rose Williams. We all know the story about this child, but if you don't know the story about this baby, the meat and potatoes of it is, just like in other story, you know, she was reported missing. Her mother is Brianna Williams, and she reported her missing. Brianna Williams was an officer down there. I want to say this is Jacksonville, Florida. She was a petty officer, something like that, down there in Jacksonville, Florida. Just all kind of foolery going on with this story. The lady she moved from the apartment they was originally in. Nobody seen the child. You know, I had to interview the two movers. I interviewed them who helped Brianna move, and they even said, you know, she claimed that the child was in the house, but they helped her move her stuff, but didn't move her child. So, you know, then talk about the child's at her grandma's house, you know, just all kind of fuckery that was going on with this story. But if you haven't, just look up the baby name and just look at all the shit that was going on with this story. Or you can look on this channel, which is the Chris Thorne Show, or my backup channel, which is the Chris Thorne Show 2.0. As a matter of fact, y'all need to go sub up to that channel, the Chris Thorne Show 2.0, because I need to put content over there. I probably gonna start doing some lives over there, you know what I'm saying, just to get the algorithm over that channel get built up, because I'm not really doing nothing with it. And if you want to subscribe to that channel, I will put that link in the description as well, the Chris Thorne Show 2.0. all right, so with that being said, here is the update. Let me move right away real quick, and let's go right here. Oops, sorry about that. We're gonna go right here. All right, so here's the update. No plea negotiations yet for Brianna Williams. So, that's another thing I want to bring up to y'all too. Brianna Williams has pled not guilty in her daughter's death. She has pled not guilty. Let me see if I can blow this up a little bit. That should be good. So as of right now, guys, on July 27th, there is no plea deal as of yet for no plea negotiation yet for Brianna Williams. So I don't know what's going on with this, but here's what it says as follows. Jacksonville mother who faces multiple charges related to the abuse of her 5-year-old daughter, who was later found dead, appeared in court Tuesday for the first time in more than a year. Brianna Williams, 29, is charged with felony aggravated child abuse, child neglect, evidence tampering, and giving false information to law enforcement in connection with the disappearance of her daughter, Taylor. She has pleaded not guilty to all of the charges. The 5-year-old girl remains were found on November 12, 2019, in a wooded area of, let's see, Marigold County in rural Alabama, 6 days after her mother of a former Navy petty officer, first class at NAS Jacksonville, reported her missing to Jacksonville Sheriff's Office. In court Tuesday, Williams' public defender said the defense is still gathering depositions, some of which it planned to collect during a visit to Alabama in December. Prosecutors are also awaiting a deposition from an expert who's helping with the Surfside collapse investigation. Court documents filed by a state attorney officer accused Williams of torturing, maliciously punishing, or caging her daughter with some time between the last time the girl was seen alive in April 2019 and November 6, 2019, when the girl was reported missing. Evidence released the case as part of a discovery suggests investigators found possible bloodstains in six places in the family's apartment, including the interior of a closet. Investigators say they found soiled children clothes, fecal matter, and soup cans with small openings. Also inside the apartment, investigators say they found the scent of decay, similar to the scent they said was noticeable in the trunk of Williams' Honda Accord. Inside the vehicle, court documents say investigators also found maggots, fecal matter, and soiled clothes. Williams faced a temporary charge because investigators suspect the girl's body was dumped in Alabama before Williams reported her missing. Records show Williams posted a Craigslist ad seeking help moving out of her apartment hours after she returned from Alabama. According to court records, a search for Williams' phone determined she made three trips to and from Linden, Alabama on October the 31st and November the 1st and November the 1st of 2019. She returned to Jacksonville shortly before 5:30 a.m. November the 3rd, 6 hours before posting the Craigslist ad online. While awaiting trial, Williams remains in custody at the Duval County Jail in lieu of $1.1 million bond. All right. And they go to the Precious Bay right here. This is another story that kind of hit hard. And it was kind of nationwide, you know. And as the story kept going, you know, we just kept hearing just fuck shit all over the place. And again, I had the pleasure to speak with the movers. Which I think her name is Tiffany Nicole, her and her fiance at the time. They may be married now, I don't know. But I had the pleasure to speak with them, and of course they told me what they experienced on that day or whatnot. And again, during the interview, they said they heard some water running in the bathroom, and Brianna stated to them that Taylor was in the bathroom. All right. So they had told me, you know, the place just was just filthy, caked up food all over the furniture and stuff. And when they figured to move the stuff, they asked where the baby was, and there was no child. So like I said, my main thing with that was, you know, I wouldn't move nothing if that child didn't come out. You know, so that's my only thing with the interview. But other than that, though, you know, great interview. They just gave their thoughts and told me what happened while they was there. All right. So right now, this story is pretty much still ongoing. Still no negotiations or anything was going to happen. So I will try to keep my eye out for this story for this precious baby right here, Taylor Rose Williams. And that's the update for today. If I have any other ones, you know, of course I will come back and give you more updates on the children who I have spoke on or whatnot. So again, Taylor Rose, you may be gone, dear, but you are not forgotten. I'm your man, Chris Thorns. Thank you for listening. As always, share your thoughts on this matter, and catch you next time. Peace.